people have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course, we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect.
Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a show where we will provide you fresh insights into South Asia's geopolitical, strategic and security situation. Let's begin the show with the headlines first. Major terror attack on army post foiled in Jammu and Kashmir's Rajouri. Soaring inflation and rising costs deepen Pakistan's economic woes. And POJK activist unveils Pakistan's malicious strategy to divert focus from region's grave situation. Jammu and Kashmir has witnessed a steep rise in terror attacks in the last few months, orchestrated by Pakistan-backed terror groups, highlighting Islamabad's relentless drive to destabilize the region. Recently, terrorists carried out an attack on security post and the House of Village Defense Guard in Rajouri area of Jammu. However, Indian Army thwarted the attack and neutralized a terrorist. We have a report.
In the early hours of July 22nd, around 4 a.m., three Pakistani terrorists launched an attack on the house of a village defense guard in the Gunda area of Rajouri, Jammu and Kashmir. The terrorist attacks initiated the assault by throwing a grenade, prompting an immediate retaliation from nearby security personnel. This clash escalated when the terrorists targeted a newly established army picket in the vicinity, resulting in a fierce exchange of fire. The Army's Nagrota-based White Knight Corps confirmed the incident on social media, stating, "Terrorists attacked the house of a VDG at Gunda Rajouri at 3:10 hours. A nearby army column retaliated and a firefight ensued. Operations are continuing." During the gunfight, one terrorist was killed, while a soldier and a civilian sustained minor injury.
This attack on the house of VDC member in Rajouri shows that these people are totally scared now, these terrorists over there, because they have realized that once the VDCs are empowered, it's going to become a problem for them to operate over there. And that is why it is required that the government should immediately strengthen the VDCs. They should give them sophisticated arms, plus they should give them wireless sets to communicate, one within the VDC group itself and the security forces, so that any time when this sort of attack happens, the VDCs can immediately inform everyone and the combined action can be taken against the terrorist.
In a separate incident, a terrorist was killed and a soldier injured during a gunfight that erupted as the Indian Army conducted a search operation in Kupwara, Jammu and Kashmir. Acting on intelligence about the presence of terrorists in Kowut, Kupwara, the Army, in collaboration with the Jammu and Kashmir Police, launched a joint operation. Tragically, a soldier was killed in action while thwarting an infiltration attempt in Poonch district near the line of control. These fresh attacks come amid a surge of terror incidents in the Jammu region, significantly heightening security concerns. Districts such as Rajouri, Poonch, Riyasi, Doda and Kathua have experienced a series of deadly assaults targeting both army personnel and civilians. In response, the army has deployed additional troops, including special paracommandos, to counter the highly trained terrorists who have been relentlessly targeting the region.
Pakistan, after seeing that their strategy is failing in Kashmir,
they thought what to do. Now they focus changed to shifted to Jammu side. There are 3-4 reasons for this. Number one, because taking advantage of the less density of the security forces. Number two, the difficult terrain, because earlier also in 2001 and 90s, this area is very active. They know what kind of terrain is there. There are thick jungles, caves and mountains. So it is very difficult to operate, especially if a militant is on top and security forces are attacking from down below. Very difficult for a militant to fire and get away and run to the higher side and go to the other side of the mountain. So operations are very difficult. They are trying to create a disturbance in Jammu region, maybe religious disturbance, Hindu-Muslim riots, and so that the attack on the Hindus by the militants can cause a sort of a disharmony in this region. So they want an whatever investment, whatever things are happening, people are developing faith in Jammu and Kashmir, that they want to remove that kind of faith and show that the government is still not reliable, the things have not worked the way the government wanted to work.
The recent spate of attacks starkly highlights Pakistan's persistent strategy to export terror and disrupt peace in India. Beyond immediate security threats, these incidents underscore deeper challenges facing Jammu and Kashmir. Despite international condemnation and the designation of groups like Jaish-e-Mohammed and Lashkar-e-Taiba as terrorist organizations by India, Pakistan continues to support and deploy these proxies in the asymmetrical warfare. Since the abrogation of Article 370 and Article 35A, security forces have intensified their efforts to combat unlawful activities aimed at destabilizing peace and unity in the Union Territory. However, even amidst rapid development and infrastructure projects, the region continues to face resistance from external forces determined to undermine its stability.
Pakistan is grappling with a severe economic crisis marked by soaring inflation and a dramatic increase in the cost of essential goods. Despite government promises of relief, many citizens feel abandoned as their daily expenses continue to rise. Residents struggling with rising costs and shrinking disposable incomes are calling out for government accountability and tangible measures to alleviate their financial burdens. A report.
Pakistan is currently facing one of its most severe economic crises in recent memory, with skyrocketing inflation rates and a steep rise in the cost of essential commodities. The middle income class, in particular, is feeling the brunt of this financial turmoil. Everyday items like gas, electricity, water and food have become increasingly expensive. According to a local media report, the prices of 25 essential items have surged dramatically, with the inflation rate now exceeding 23%. Despite government assurances of relief, the cost of living continues to escalate.
महंगाई तो ये हुकूमत के ऊपर है भाई, जो गरीबों के ऊपर रहम खाए, गरीबों को मदद करे, सपोर्ट करे उन लोगों भाई, लोग रोड पे काम कर रहे हैं, लोग आके उन लोग से पूछे, हाल अहवाल पूछे, आप लोग क्या कर रहे हो इधर, क्या नहीं कर रहे हो, कोई पूछने वाला नहीं, अल्लाह के सवा रिक्स रोजी अल्लाह देने वाला, ये लोग नहीं देते भाई, ये लोग बोलते बोले गरीब मरना तो मरने दो.
Petrol prices have surged by 9.99 Pakistani rupees per litre, setting the new price at rupees 275.60 per litre. High-speed diesel prices have also seen a significant rise, with an increase of rupees 6.18 Pakistani rupees per litre, bringing the new price to rupees 283.63 per litre. These hikes are part of the government's efforts to reduce subsidies and address fiscal deficits, but have had a cascading effect on transportation and production costs.
महंगाई तो हर जगह हो रही है, आप ऊपर देखे देखे हर बंदा परेशान है, मगर अल्लाह करम कर देता है, बस ये जो लोगों का राशन जैसे 20-25 हज़ार में आया था अब 30-40 हज़ार के अंदर आ रहा है। अब हम रिक्शा चलाने वाले हैं, पहले हम सवारी से लेते थे 150 रुपए, अब हम 300 रुपए ले रहे हैं क्योंकि गैस महंगी हो गई है।
The Shehbaz Sharif-led government has also increased the base tariff of electricity prices for domestic consumers to up to 48.84 Pakistani rupees. Despite pre-election promises of relief, many citizens feel abandoned as the cost of basic necessities continues to rise.
इन्हीं ने ऐलान किया था कि हम आपको बिजली में रिलीफ देंगे। अब वही बिल जो है 3-3 हज़ार 5-5 हज़ार रुपए का आ रहा है। क्या रिलीफ दिया इन्होंने हमारे लिए? क्या किया? जब इलेक्शन होता है तब आके पूछते हैं क्या हाल है, उसके बाद ये पूछने वाला कोई नहीं है। हर चीज़ आसमान की तरफ जा रही है। एक महीना पेट्रोल सस्ता किया, दूसरे महीने महंगा कर दिया इन्होंने। क्या करेंगे? दालें महंगी, चावल महंगे, आटा महंगा, चीनी महंगी, यहाँ तक कि पानी भी महंगा है। ये हुक्मरान क्या कर रहे हैं? एसी के कमरों में बैठते हैं, एसी की गाड़ियों में घूमते हैं, एसी के घरों में चले जाते हैं। हम यहाँ रोड के ऊपर मजदूरी कर रहे हैं समझे, इसके बावजूद हमारी कोई सुनवाई नहीं है।
The soaring cost of living is pushing basic necessities out of reach for many. Middle-income class families are struggling as their disposable incomes shrink and low-income groups are being pushed further into poverty.
जो वादे किए थे आवाम से वो एक वादा भी पूरा नहीं किया इन्होंने। और ये सच्चाई वो सच्चाई, पेट्रोल महंगा, दुनिया भर की चीजें, हमारा 100 यूनिट का अगर बिल है तो 3-3 हज़ार रुपए का भेज रहे हैं। हमारे लिए क्या रिलीफ दे रहे हो? अगर हम जाते हैं, अगर हम अपना बिल सही कराने के लिए जाते हैं तो बोलते हैं ये तो आपको भरना पड़ेगा। ये जो वादे किए थे 100 यूनिट 200 यूनिट उसके लिए रिलीफ होगा, फ्री होगा। क्या क्या फ्री दे रहे हो आप? टीवी में बोलते हो फ्री देंगे, यहाँ पे कोई चीज़ फ्री नहीं है। या चाहे काम है या नहीं है, इनका बिल भरो। हमने अपने घर के बर्तन बेच दिए, अपने घर का सामान बेच दिया, हम किराए के ऊपर आ गए, लेकिन तुम्हारा पूरा नहीं हो रहा है यहाँ पे, हम कैसे पूरा करें?
As Pakistan continues to grapple with these economic challenges, the call for government accountability and tangible relief measures grow louder, highlighting the urgent need for effective solutions to stabilize the economy and support its citizens.
A Pakistan-occupied Jammu Kashmir activist has harshly criticized Pakistan for its hypocrisy and its role in worsening conditions in the illegally occupied territory. He blamed Islamabad for orchestration of terror attacks in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and using the Hurriyat Conference to fuel anti-India propaganda, all while diverting the global attention from the dire situation in POJK. The activist highlighted ongoing civil disobedience movement in POJK and POJB, where thousands protested against unfair taxes and severe shortages of essentials like food and electricity. Amid worsening conditions and administrative suppression, there is a growing unrest among the locals. We have a report.
They are trying to divert the attention of international media and international human rights observers from what is going on in Pakistani occupied Jammu Kashmir.
In a recently released video statement, Dr. Amjad Ayub Mirza, a POJK activist, lambasted Pakistan for its hypocrisy and undermining the situation in the illegally occupied territory of POJK.
Hurriyat Conference was created by the ISI.
The activist exposed Pakistan's hypocrisy, who is behind orchestration of terror attacks in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and using organizations like the Hurriyat Conference for running anti-India propaganda, while also diverting attention from the critical condition in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir.
The recent conference of all parties Hurriyat Conference in Pakistan and Lahore that was held on the 18th and 19th of July, basically is trying to give legitimacy to the attacks that are taking place in Jammu. These attacks are caused by infiltration of Pakistani-based proxy terrorists. And All Party Hurriyat Conference is now asking the world community to look into the atrocities that are taking place against the general population of Indian Union Territory, Jammu Kashmir, by Indian government. They are trying to divert the attention of international media and international human rights observers from what is going on in Pakistani-occupied Jammu Kashmir. The fact of the matter is that in Pakistani-occupied Jammu Kashmir, there is a civil disobedience movement.
Mirza highlighted ongoing civil disobedience in POJK and Pakistan-occupied Gilgit-Baltistan, where thousands are protesting against unjust taxes on electricity bills. For over seven decades, the illegally occupied POJK has been deprived of basic amenities, and the ongoing inflation in the region has aggravated the struggle of the general public to sustain their livelihoods. The activist further highlighted the severe shortages of basic necessities, including electricity, flour and wheat, and the revocation of subsidies on essential food items in POJK.
Pakistan has imposed illegal and unjust taxes on the people of Pakistani-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. There is no electricity, there is no flour, there is a crisis of wheat because they have cut the subsidies. The population has grown and the allocation of wheat and flour to various places inside POJK has not been revised. So there is a crisis of democracy, there is a crisis of economic rights, there is a crisis of ownership of resources in POJK.
It has been over a year since the residents of POJK have been protesting against inflated electricity bills and high prices of wheat, flour and other essential food items. But the local administration, in cahoots with Islamabad, has regularly snubbed these protests and demands of the locals. Amidst inflation and a high degree of suppression from the administration, matters are worsening in POJK. There are signs of unrest brewing among the locals, and it would be no surprise if yet another massive protest against Pakistan and its stooge administration erupts across the illegally occupied territory in the coming times.
In Pakistan's Bannu district of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province, thousands of protesters are holding a sit-in following a violent crackdown on their peaceful march by authorities on July 19th. The shooting resulted in one death and several injuries, leading to sharp criticism from human rights organizations. This incident underscores growing frustration with Pakistan's military and administration, raising questions about their approach to handling dissent and human rights abuses in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa.
In northwest Pakistan, thousands of protesters are staging a sit-in after authorities opened fire on a peaceful march in Bannu district of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province on July 19. The Bannu Chambers of Commerce and Industry organized the protest, which has drawn large crowds from local areas and neighboring regions, including Mardan, Lucky Marwat and Swabi. Demonstrators who have gathered at Maulana Abdul Sattar Shah Chowk are calling for an end to military operations in the area. Pashtun leaders have condemned the violence used against protesters in the Bannu district.
फौज ने, सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस ने स्टेट फायर करके और अमन मुजाहिर लाखों की तादाद में लोग अमन के लिए निकले थे, सफेद झंडों के साथ निकले थे, उनके ऊपर स्ट्रेट फायर की है, उससे कई लोग शहीद हो गए हैं और कई जख्मी हैं। अभी मैं हॉस्पिटल में, बनी हॉस्पिटल में बहुत से जख्मी आए हैं, बिल्कुल स्ट्रेट फायर करके लोगों को मार दिया गया है। मैं इसकी मजम्मत करता हूँ, अगर सरकारी रियासती दहशत गर्दी है ये काबिल मजम्मत है।
The shooting at the rally resulted in one death and several injuries. The suspension of mobile phone and internet services has compounded the difficulties for locals and disrupted businesses. Protesters have expressed their dismay over the continuing violence and have called for a new approach that includes parliamentary discussions. Amnesty International, a human rights organization, criticized the authorities' use of violence to break up the march, saying that the use of lethal force at a peaceful rally advocating for peace is unlawful. Mutahida Qawami Movement, MQM, founder Altaf Hussain recently criticized the tactics of Pakistan's defense forces, accusing them of attempting to discredit communities that protest peacefully.
Aman march karne wale.
Hussain highlighted a press conference held by the Directorate of Inter Services Public Relations, where they alleged that the firing at the Bannu rally was initiated by the protesters.
Bannu mein pur amn, aman march karne wale. जो हाथों में सफायत परचम लिए अमन की दुहाइयां देते हुए जा रहे थे और आपके फौजियों ने उन पर फायरिंग की, तो आपने झूठ बोला कि नहीं, उनमें से ही कुछ लोगों ने फायरिंग की। और एक तस्वीर आपने दिखाई कि किसी के हाथ में पिस्टल, अगर थी भी पिस्टल, इसका क्या सबूत है कि वो आपके किसी ISI के अहलकार के हाथ की हाथ में नहीं थी? क्या सबूत है कि वो पुरम जो शुरका थे जुलूस में शरीक अमन मार्च के, उनमें से किसी के पास थी? अच्छा, अगर थी भी तो आपके पास तो इतनी बड़ी बड़ी बंदूकें हैं, जदीद तरीन बंदूकें हैं। आपने जिस तरीके से फायरिंग की, आपने दूसरी तस्वीर नहीं दिखाई?
The Pashtun community's outrage is fueled by a history of violence and human rights abuses in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province of Pakistan. The persistent aggression by defense forces, along with the government's inaction, has led to widespread resentment and anger toward both the military and the administration in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province. Recent events suggest that the Pakistan government is unwilling to change its approach, continuing to impose stricter measures despite growing unrest.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We'll be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@anin.com. This is Shivangi Mishra signing off on behalf of the entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.
People have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course, we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect.